So what we're doing today is we're going to review the cell cycle, and then we're going to do a lab. We're going to look at some cells going through the different stages of mitosis, and then we're going to start our cancer research activity. Okay?
Initially, changing to proficiency-based was difficult, but now I can't imagine doing anything differently. It makes so much more sense. The whole idea is that I want them to be able to diagram a cell going through cell division and pick out key features of cells going through those different phases. And they should be able to label the different parts of the cell, and eventually they'll have an assessment where I give them really similar looking cells and ask them to look at the cell, determine what phase it is, but then also to be able to explain what's happening in that phase.
The microscopes that we're using today, you're not really going to be able to see the centrosomes, but during certain stages you'll see the spindle fibers that they're sending out to move those chromosomes. Right here is where you want to focus. This is where the cells are going through mitosis.
And we're at the point in the year where I have a pretty good sense. I can kind of guess who might need a little bit more of my help in those situations too. I try to give it, really spread it around, but I can guess who's going to need a little bit more guidance. You know, I go over to the microscope, and with one student, I might, because I know that there's some other things going on, I might, you know, really get them focused, pinpoint a cell, really walk them through the cell. Whereas with another student, I might still have them drive and just walk them through. So I try to really know kind of where that student's at ahead of time and determine like how much of me they need. Most of those cells are an interface. All right, so just pick one of them and you can draw it. And then what you're seeing is that dark circle is the chromatin, that's the DNA inside. We're heterogeneously grouped, and so I've got kids of all different skill level. And I tried to structure groups in a way so that I could meet with one group that needed a lot more help, and then structured groups where I knew that they would be a little bit more independent. So even though they were working on the same project, how they're doing it is different, and the level of support that I'm giving them is different. I build formatives into my slideshows also, and I use Pear Deck often to just sort of do these quick assessments. Are we understanding as a group? And then I also do warm-ups to remind them about what we did last class usually, and just make sure we're all on the same page moving on to this next thing. And that gives me a good idea of the entire group. But as far as individuals, I really try to go through my gradebook. That one-on-one piece is still really, really important. It's just being able to find the time to do that. And that's really going to be important for clarifying at that formative level before they move on to the summative level. Remember what I said about, are you looking for metaphase? Remember, metaphase kind of looks like a spider.
Okay, I don't know.
Prophase just has the little dots, right?
You can see the little chromosomes, right?
You can go to your teacher and ask, like, hey, like, what can I do in this section to, like, make my grade better? And, like, what do I need to add? Or, like, you know, like, what I did good and bad. And I think it, like, really reflects on, like, where you're strong and where you aren't strong. It tells you what you need to do better and like what you're doing fine with.
So I like the heterogeneous grouping. I think there are pluses and minuses, but overall I think the pluses outweigh the minuses. I think that it's really wonderful to see some students who are excelling, who are understanding everything. They're always sort of at that front edge in my classroom. If I can give them that leadership role where I actually ask them to, hey, can you match up with this kid and help them with these questions? It makes them feel good. It helps their understanding too, because you know that really is this whole other level of understanding if you can explain it to someone else.
It just like feels good, you know, like looking at the grades and it says like, oh, you're proficient in this kind of standard, you're good at this, things like that. It's just like, wow, I did good at that. I can keep like doing that. Like I can do things I didn't think I could, you know. Everyone, if they want to learn more, if they want to get that A+, if they want to strive to be great, they can do it.
The assignment that you guys all have a copy of is this cancer pamphlet. So what you're going to do is you're going to research a cancer, and I've got a list of possible cancers right here. You don't have to choose from this list.
I do think the element of choice is important. I try to add that in as much as possible. So whether that's sort of the more traditional element of choice where they can choose whether to do their cell analogy, for example, on a poster or a model, or to make a slideshow.
Right down here, you have a graphic organizer. The rubric that I'm going to be using is linked right here. You can just fill out this organizer. And then this organizer, if you do a good job, that's a C. Okay? If you want to go for more than that, though, then what you're going to do is you're going to take this information and you're going to create a pamphlet. Whenever I assign a summative assessment, I also will push out the rubric to them so they see it ahead of time. And the students who tend to do really well on the summative assessments are looking at the rubrics in addition to the instructions to see how I'm going to grade it. And they're going to make sure, they kind of see it as a checklist, like, do I have these pieces? But I also try and do a little bit of layering curriculum. So I'll have a project with these layered elements in it where they can choose if they're going for the A or the B or the C level. I like to call it a la carte. Choose which pieces of that project to do to complete to get that level that they've chosen. And obviously they should all choose the A. And that's why I really have them push for. It's a great opportunity for kids that maybe, you know, on a test, they get some test anxiety. It's not necessarily the best way for them to show how much they know, but if they kind of have a little bit more control over what they can use to communicate their understanding, that's when I can really get a better understanding of what they know.